Alright, we're back for part 4 of Senseless Acts of Justice. We just got our 3 locations, and now let's just check a couple of them out. Let's go to the Beef Mart first. Wow, that's tasty. What is this, flies?
Meat's so rank, those flies have turned vegan. Never know when you're gonna need a mitt full of dead bugs.
Alright.
I'd like a pound of bollocks, please, my good man. A pound of... Wait a minute! I know that voice! Hector, you old truffle pig. Still snuffling around in the offal, I see.
How's the bloodlust, beef cheeks? Slaughtered anything hairy lately?
Well, I never. Old Hector, it's been a while since you graced these parts. You gone veggie or something?
Not a chance. Still as carnivorous as ever. The preferred mealtime dish is still meat with a side order of meat, washed down with a glass of meat.
Ha ha, taking your lunchtime bite is still the classic Hector sandwich.
Indeed it is. One slice of buttered bread between two slabs of cooked ham.
Oh, Hector, we shared such fond meat-themed good times. I've yet to meet anyone that appreciates a boneless shin as much as you do. Now, what can I do for you, old friend?
You've always been my go-to guy on meat-connected cases, right?
Aye, we've had some fantastic, disgusting times, haven't we?
You're not kidding. Remember the dramatic conclusion of the baby back rib roast murders of 95?
The rib roast! Oh my godfathers, that takes me back. I've still got some of it under my fingernails.
Listen, Kentuckan, I need you to take a look at something for me.
Seems I've done more favours for you than I've had gristle in me teeth.
Well, don't forget, I did let you in on one of the only 2 methods of how to legally kill someone.
Only I wish I knew that before they put me away for 12 years. You still haven't told me the second method.
Maybe one of these days.
I'll hold you to that. Now, what have you got?
Get your schnozzle round that. Tell me what you make of it.
Interesting.
Oh god, he just didn't lick it.
Narrowing it down. The protein traces are a young breed. Continental European, possibly Charolais.
What about the sauce itself?
Well, the sauce-based ingredients are from a recognizable supply, but have been simmered in a large vat, made in bulk, and filled out with cheap white vinegar.
I don't need a full ingredients list, just take a swing at it.
If I had to make a call, I'd say it has all the hallmarks of Chez Le Buffet restaurant. Except? Something tells me it's not their usual in-house formula. It's been a while since I tore up a Hereford Angus in there, but judging by this, their quality has considerably dropped. Anyway, that's about as close as I'm gonna get you.
Thanks, old friend.
Don't mention it. To anyone. Seriously though, don't.
Okay, yet another location. Alright.
Do you supply to Chez Le Buffet?
No longer. When they said they were expanding into a new business venture exploiting every part of the carcass including the hoof, I had to draw a line.
You never told me you had standards.
What can I say? Beef is my life.
Always a pleasure.
Don't be a stranger.
Is this blood?
I call it Nosferatu's Delight.
Sounds ominous. What's in it?
It's a black pudding flavoured frappuccino smoothly.
So it's blood in a slushy machine.
94% genuine livestock blood with a hint of basil. Take some if you like, on the house, old mate.
That may come in handy at some point, but right now we have no container. Let's see. Let's go to Doreen's.
Doreen's mail bar and army surplus. Beauty products and guns. I just sprang me brain thinking about it. And while we're at it, who are these clowns? Hot diggity, you're pale. Did you forget to remove your shirt before adding the bleach?
Been sitting on this plastic chair all day, hooked up, waiting for my art to pump some blood into my arm to earn a bit of hard cash.
And I thought my day was crap. Why don't you try getting your blood pumping, like doing some star jumps?
I was gonna jog round the van earlier, but it made me lightheaded and nauseous before I'd even left the chair.
Yeah, jogging has that same effect on me. Well, for the 10 seconds I accidentally tried it, it did, nearly through a bilious attack. I brought bodies to the morgue that were fresher than you.
Hey, you seem like a nice guy. Think you could help me out a bit?
I know I'm gonna regret this, but how?
Just a pint or two, just to get me through to the end of the week.
Are we talking lager here?
No, blood, please. Just enough to fill this bag, then I can stop at the chippy on the way home.
Your kids need a father more than they need chips.
They'll manage.
So, what brings you to the drip for Dosh?
You would not believe how much the demand for door-to-door office supplies has plummeted.
I blame the internet, but then I blame the internet for just about everything.
I've turned to selling my own rapidly diminishing blood. If I don't, my wife will be forced to shop at Lidl.
Look, I've already established you're a loser. There's no need to give me the backstory to prove it. It's been real.
Let's talk to this guy.
Excuse me.
Visit.
Alrighty, let's talk to,
I'll steal yourself. Who knows what's in there?
Damn, shock horror! The bags and beyond sales assistant lifts the last Gigi Logie out of the window and sells it?
No.
I knew, I practically died right there.
What did you do?
Well, what any girl would, of course. I waited patiently for the cow to exit the shop, and I shot her in a fat leg.
You didn't.
I did her a favour. She would have been the Queen of Ming with that handbag and her permatan.
What did you use, the semi-auto?
Yup, good old dependable semi. You're absolutely right, very practical.
I can tell you now, it'll come in super handy when sale season rolls round. Welcome to Doreen's Nail Bar and Army Surplus, Clapper's Rig's foremost destination for all your manicure and military needs.
Okay. Alright, let's look around, shall we?
Scary female alert. Buggeration puts the twat weapon stash to shame. Gift baskets of scented oils for loved ones. Gift baskets of live grenades for loathed ones.
Hilarious.
The opposite of scary female. Good day, miss.
It's Mrs. actually. Mrs. Leisha Pelchester of the Pelchesters. Perhaps you've heard of me?
You mean the Pelchesters?
The very same. Shorty's my husband.
Really? And are you his wife?
Yes.
You're joking.
I'm so not.
Wait a second. Polchester. Shorty Polchester of Clatters United.
The very same.
Oh, Shorty. I've lost many a shilling to that overpaid groin injury and overrated public tosspot. Say, wasn't he the one that got the entire English women's football team pregnant during a 2007 World Cup training session in the Algarve?
You didn't believe that story, did you? You're probably one of those guys that reads the papers.
So you're the latest bit of crumpet that's masquerading as Shorty's missus, then?
The latest? The one and only, you mean? The love of Shorty's life.
But I thought Shorty was shacked up with some brunette tart that used to present the coveted 3 to 4 p.m. jewellery section of the PVC shopping channel. Just once I wish I could have been that 4-carat sovereign pendant depicting the entire cast of Hotel Babylon she was running her fingers over.
It was 8-carat, thank you very much.
That was you? Well, bugger me. So, you and Shorty are a happy pair then?
Totally. The press even have a name for us, you know, like Brangelina or Benifer. They call us Shisha.
Good job your name wasn't Kitty.
Silly. My name is Leisha.
Getting ahead to Dome Makeover. Big night planned.
Every night's a big night when you're me, darling. Tonight I've managed to pull some strings and get us a romantic table for two at Sexy Chic Shayla Buffet.
Bedroom eyes from Shorty and a steaming trough of warm meat. That's actually on my bucket list.
Honey, it's on everybody's bucket list.
I hate that phrase, bucket list.
Ciao, darling.
Alright, let's see what Doreen has to say.
I'm Detective Inspector Hector. I'm investigating a terrorist attack that occurred earlier today.
Are you now? Well, I don't mind telling you, I have a bit of a thing for the good guys. I'd love to find out what's really behind the badge.
Oh, bugger. Not one of these conversations. Are you the owner of this establishment?
I am indeed. Doreen's the name. Pleasure to meet you.
Well, you don't know that yet, do you?
Well, you're pleasurable to my eye so far.
You really think so?
I'll try anything once.
What sort of services do you offer here?
Our services include manicures, pedicures, oiling, barrel scouring, waxing, tanning, reloading, calibrating, head and hand massage, firing pin or hair replacement and therapy.
What sort of therapy?
Anything from aroma to post-traumatic stress.
Wow.
Would you mind examining an item I have in my possession?
Oh, I'll examine anything you like, big stuff.
Look, I thought very hard about that last sentence to phrase it in a way that you couldn't possibly think I was flirting with you. If I'd said, would you mind running your hands over me weapon, it would have been a totally different story.
I don't know what you're on about.
Do you do gift vouchers?
We do. Available on request after a 3-day waiting period and full background check.
Do you have a license to sell weapons?
Of course I do. I'm legal. Barely.
Good lord.
I need to know if you've retained any record of who purchased this rifle.
Very bad shape. Yeah, I remember this one. Took me a while to get the shaft sprung correctly. I'm sure you don't have that problem, officer.
Oh. Do you know who last acquired it?
I might. Over there I have a filing cabinet with all the signed sales receipts from the past 30 days. But I operate on a strict privacy guarantee with all my customers.
Oh, just what I need. An honest criminal. Seriously, I need that information.
I can't just hand over my keys to any man who walks in off the street. I get repeat business because I'm faithful to my customers. I'm just a faithful kind of girl. Except when I'm not.
Oh, cripes. Look, it's really important that I get into your filing cabinet.
Sorry, you're not getting any access to my private area.
Oh, don't say it. Don't say it.
At least not until you've taken me out to dinner first.
Oh, can't take much more of her. Doreen.
I like you, Hector. It's undeniable there's chemistry between us.
The only thing between us is a glass cabinet full of merkins and a sense of awkwardness.
You really want access to my private records? Let's just say I'm willing to be persuaded.
By records, you actually mean the physical ones with customer signatures on.
Oh, it'll be physical, all right. Geez, you never let up with your flirting, do you?
I can assure you that's the last thing I'm doing. Oh, are you asking me out?
No, you're asking me out. I've got something you want, and you've got something I want.
What do I have, dare I ask, that you want?
I'd like to learn more about your interrogation techniques.
I'll bring me truncheon.
Oh, now you're talking.
Okay.